He was the first real big star of the stock market, okay? Because for a year and a half, everybody who followed him made a lot of money. And that creates a lot of loyalty, fan following. He was the first ever broker to feature on the covers of so many magazines. Story ye thi ki Harshad Mehta ne State Bank of India se 500 crores liye the aur he was not in a position to pay it back. State Bank ke books mein tha ki there is a receipt against a certain transaction in government securities, when in fact there was no transaction and the money had gone to Harshad Mehta. SBI ke vigilance department ne aur SBI ke chairman ne Harshad Mehta ko wahan pe bulaya tha to recover the money aur un dinon mein किसी की लेक्सस कार होती नहीं थी, तो जब हर्षद मेहता की यू नो वेरी एक्सपेंसिव 40 लाख लेक्सस कार एसबीआई में गई, तो वो सिर्फ कार देखने के लिए बहुत सारे लोग इकट्ठा.
फ्रेंड्स, सुचिता दलाल जी का इंटरव्यू अभी आगे और भी है. मुझे बस आपको इतना बताना है कि अगर आप उनके बारे में पूरी डिटेल जानना चाहते हैं तो मैंने इसी वीडियो में उनके बारे में बता रखा है, तो आप वीडियो को एंड तक ज़रूर देखिएगा.
रिजर्व बैंक ने स्टेट बैंक को पूछा कि एक ब्रोकर इतना बड़ा चेक कहाँ से दे सकता है, तो हमको वो चेक देखना है. और तभी पता चला कि चेक आया था नेशनल हाउसिंग बैंक से, विच वॉज इवन मोर स्कैंडलस, क्योंकि नेशनल हाउसिंग बैंक इज अ डायरेक्ट सब्सिडियरी ऑफ द रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया, विच इज द मॉनिटरी अथॉरिटी. और फिर आरबीआई आस्क्ड नेशनल हाउसिंग बैंक, ऑन व्हाट बेसिस डिड यू गिव द मनी टू हर्षद मेहता to pay State Bank, and then they got to know that the money had come from ANZ Greenlays. So then RBI went to investigate ANZ Greenlays, and at that stage unko pata chala ki it is not about one bank, every bank was involved. Andhra Bank, Canara Bank, Standard Chartered, Citibank, Hong Kong Bank, you name it, and they were involved, including very small cooperative banks, and it was like a, you know, a daisy chain. हर्षद मेहता का रियल इनकम और जो पैसा उनके पास था टू पंप अप स्टॉक्स, वो आ रहा था गवर्नमेंट सिक्योरिटीज मार्केट से. सो और गवर्नमेंट सिक्योरिटीज मार्केट कंप्लीटली बिहाइंड द सीन्स शैडो ही अननोन था. तो ये जो घोटाला हुआ वो एक्चुअली मेनली स्टॉक मार्केट स्कैम नहीं था, इट वॉज अ गवर्नमेंट सिक्योरिटीज स्कैम.
सुचेता दलाल 1992 में स्टॉक मार्केट के देश के सबसे बड़े घोटाले का पर्दाफाश करने वाली महिला पत्रकार थी. इनके प्रयास से ही 1992 का घोटाला उजागर हुआ और आरोपी हर्षद मेहता को जेल हुई. इसके कारण से वह काफ़ी फेमस हुई और इन्हें कई पुरस्कार से सम्मानित किया गया. सुचेता दलाल का जन्म 1962 में मुंबई में हुआ और इनकी प्रारंभिक शिक्षा मुंबई में संपन्न हुई और उन्होंने स्टैटिस्टिक्स में अपनी ग्रेजुएशन की पढ़ाई कर्नाटक के कॉलेज से पूरी की. इसके बाद उन्होंने बॉम्बे यूनिवर्सिटी से LLB और LLM की डिग्री हासिल करी. सुचिता दलाल को बचपन से ही बिजनेस के सब्जेक्ट बहुत पसंद था और पत्रकार बनना उनका सपना, और आगे चलकर वह बिजनेस पत्रकार बनी. बाद में वह देवाशीष बासु से विवाह कर लेती हैं. सुचिता दलाल ने अपना करियर 1984 में फॉर्च्यून इंडिया से शुरू किया था और वह 1990 में मुंबई के टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया को ज्वाइन कर लेती हैं. बाद में वह टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया की वित्तीय संपादक बन जाती हैं और 1998 तक फिर टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया का हिस्सा रहती हैं. साल 2006 में उनके पति देवाशीष बासु ने निवेश करके मनी लाइफ नाम की मैगजीन स्टार्ट करते हैं, जिसके लिए सुचिता दलाल लिखना शुरू कर देती हैं. वर्तमान में सुचिता दलाल मनी लाइफ पत्रिका के प्रबंधक संपादक हैं. टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया में रहकर इन्होंने हर्षद मेहता के स्टॉक मार्केट के बिजनेस की छानबीन करते हुए हर्षद मेहता के घोटालों को पर्दाफाश किया था. सुचिता हर्षद मेहता के घोटालों के बारे में बताती हैं कि वह कैसे बैंकों में अपनी जान पहचान का फ़ायदा उठाकर बैंकों से 15 दिन के लिए लोन लेता है और किस प्रकार उसके बैंकों और अन्य लोगों से 4000 करोड़ रुपये का घोटाला करते हैं. सुचिता दलाल ने हर्षद मेहता घोटाले के अलावा और भी कई घोटालों की पोल खोली है, जैसे CR भंसाली स्कैम, एनरॉन स्कैम, IDBI स्कैम और केतन पारेख स्कैम. सुचिता दलाल द्वारा लिखी गई कई प्रसिद्ध पुस्तकें हैं, जैसे कि द स्कैम हु वन हु लॉस्ट हु गॉट अवे, AD श्रॉफ, टाइटन ऑफ फाइनेंस एंड फ्री एंटरप्राइज. साल 2006 में सुचिता दलाल को एपीजे अब्दुल कलाम जी से पद्मश्री अवार्ड मिला था। इसके अलावा मीडिया फाउंडेशन द्वारा स्थापित चमला देवी पुरस्कार भी मिला। 1992 में हर्षद मेहता प्रकाशन पर काम और संबंधित लेखन के लिए फेमिना की वुमेन ऑफ सब्सटेंस डिग्री से सम्मानित किया गया। सुचिता दलाल वर्तमान में अहमदाबाद के उपभोक्ता शिक्षा और अनुसंधान केंद्र की ट्रस्टी हैं। इसके अलावा वह बैंक ऑफ बड़ौदा की स्थायी समिति के सदस्य के साथ साथ सुचिता दलाल एडवर्टाइजिंग स्टैंडर्ड्स काउंसिल ऑफ इंडिया की उपभोक्ता शिकायत परिषद के सदस्य भी हैं। तो फ्रेंड्स, अगर आपको सुचिता दलाल की बायोग्राफी पसंद आई तो वीडियो को लाइक करें, शेयर करें और हाँ, सब्सक्राइब जरूर करें।
That's a very long story, I don't know. But I can say that I had the opportunity to have exposure in my life of ups and downs, of various different business, going through the different cycles, business cycles. If I go back in my olden days, yes, I feel that I don't think any MBAs or any business person gets this kind of exposure. Like what all I have got, and I got the practical exposure.
Now that you're out, you say that you can resolve the entire crisis of confidence in the market, restore monies to the people who have lost it, and build back things to their old standing.
I think there is again a little misinformation. I am not that capable. And this I want to remove this I part of it, but I am quite conscious from day one that we don't want to make anybody to suffer because of our non-payment. Anybody's due, especially any bank, will not suffer any money, at least on Harshad Mehta's account. I had put in a lot of efforts. I had put in efforts to call on the banks. I had put in efforts to write letters to FM, to RBI governor. I had all the while been saying, probably this may be one of the most unique case that on one side, such a huge outstanding is there, and there is not a single claimant coming up. Even custodian hasn't got a single claim against Harshad Mehta. Then I am just to ask, where is the case? What's the question? And NHB fighting with Greenlays, State Bank fighting with Greenlays and NHB. I am saying, Baba, you are fighting for me. I am here. I am prepared to come forward. You just work out. Just spare your person and let's sit together. We don't know you. Straight, this has been the answer, and it was so shocking. So probably,
maybe you owe nobody no money.
I will like you to. I beg your pardon.
I said, maybe you owe nobody no money.
That's a great situation. But I am more concerned. It's probably beyond few crores. I don't need money. And it starts giving you negative effect than the positive. I don't want to pass on that poison to my son.
Have your family taken it?
Already we are having two views. I was on the one side of having so much of ambitious plans, and the other side my family has always been saying, what all and why all? So this gave them the reason that, but they all has, I mean, this has been the opportunity again, we call it the calamity converted into opportunity. And I am seeing a point in their saying something, and they are also seeing some point in my saying. We have been able to resolve.
There is a groundswell of opinion that maybe you have been discriminated against. What do you feel about that?
We have written a letter to JPC, as I feel that really JPC is one forum which can act on what all discrimination has been brought out to. First discrimination is that in nobody's case, the whole family is notified. Virtually today, I am left without any asset or any money. even for my brother's operation, which I requested to get 30,000 sanction for the operation expenses, I was denied on that. That's on one side. The number of cases filed against me, in every case it is just one FIR, but in my cases there are 7 FIRs being filed by different defendants. In case of my membership, not only my membership has been taken up, but my family, my brother's membership at stock exchange, or my wife's membership also has been taken up. It has been suspended. They are suspended as a member. Number of agencies going after me. It was not only income tax slapping a huge, ridiculous amount of 10,000 crore and odd as income tax. Good that will help me to be getting one of a noted person in Guinness Book of Record, having the highest tax liability on. So this all leads me to think on that. Yes, I am discriminated, not in one case, not in once. If one area is there, it can be a chance, but not all.
In other words, other people have got away scot-free. You got more than your punishment due.
I won't say that they have got scot-free, but I will say this way, that I am being penalized more than what I should be.
How does it feel to be free after 111 days?
It took me quite some time to get back to normal, because in this 111 days, it happened so many times. Every time when I was going to the court, I was just under the impression that ki bhi aaj chhut jaunga ya agle tarikh ko chhut jaunga. And it was even Justice Varyava once mentioned that this is the last time. Then that was ending on 30th June. पर हर वक्त यही आता गया, पता नहीं कहाँ से क्या हो रहा है, समथिंग कमिंग अप अगेन. एंड एट वन पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम देर वर टू और थ्री एजेंसीज वेटिंग टू पाउंस ऑन मी एज इफ आई वॉज समथिंग अ कमोडिटी, वेरी स्केर्स कमोडिटी. सो दैट मेड मी लेटली टू फील दैट एज इफ आई एम गोइंग टू टेक क्वाइट अ लॉन्ग टाइम बिफोर कमिंग आउट. एंड द डे व्हेन आई हर्ड दिस हिज वर्डिक्ट जस्टिस डू दैट वर्डिक्ट, I was not ready to believe it. I asked my lawyer, are you sure? Is there anybody waiting or anything else is hanging? Because again, after his verdict, it took one day for Vaikala jail to release me. They were also not sure what to do. They were so much habitual of me, they was not wanting to allow me
to be a free man. Public hero to public villain number one, to back to being public hero. It's been several swings up and down. How do you cope with your current reincarnation as public hero?
Only one and one, my request is, I don't want bookies, don't give me brickbats. It's too much of a swing from top to the bottom, again bringing it back, and I won't say that I am hero. Let me be what I am, and I am proud of what I am, that's all.
You turn out to be a scapegoat in this whole scam, as they call it.
I just don't feel only. I have tried to even bring out in a very detailed manner, expressing how I am being victimized, how things are being discriminated against me. Like with other players, only first of all, the big gap is that this whole scam or whatever you call irregularities has been not committed by any one person or any one group of persons. It is the whole business. Lately it came out that yes, it has been the system of the market, and 80% of the trading volume has been going beyond RBI regulations. And to the surprise, even now the confession is there from the RBI that they were aware of it since last more than a year. So if they couldn't change it, banks, who were the deciding authority, who were the one who had the more of a say in the market. Brokers are the small segment of the whole market.
You stirred a hornet's nest by referring to Citibank's involvement in the scam, for which they've threatened to sue you, I'm told.
I haven't received any official communication from them, but that was somebody just now was mentioning that a newspaper is carrying a story there in Delhi that they plan to sue me. Fine, before that let them sue Janakiraman committee report and Janakiraman committee. Let them answer that.
You feel that the media has been fair to you or unfair?
I will put it this way, that media has been reacting extremes all the time. And virtually I can say that nobody has understood exactly what all has happened. And everybody has tried to explain the situation in their own fashion. And so much has come that if I read all the news, then I also will get confused of what exactly has happened. So I don't know what happens to the common man who has just been fed with so many informations and so many misinformations.
What do you think, put into an absolute nutshell, actually happened? What went wrong?
I think today I am not in a position to talk this, as matter is sub judice, and it will be adding to more of confusion, because now the fact won't remain as fact with the background what all has been created. So better let me reserve my part of the view on that.
What do you see as the future of the stock market? Of the Indian stock market, that is.
I had been saying, and I am still very firm about it, that India is a turnaround stock on the global exchange. And it has all the signs, this Asian tiger is coming out of the cage. It's only a matter, I will not suggest for the speculators or short-term trader. I had always been talking about investors, and investors, if you go on, even averaging out on index basis also has made substantial money. Forget about the specialization and specialized approach. And it's not my view only, by the time already now, like Morgan Stanley has already declared that how India is potential. And I, being a creature of this market and what close with so much of a closeness I have been able to see this market, I feel we have one of the greatest potential markets.
Why did the stock market not suddenly welcome you out with open arms as one had expected them to?
They have become more sensible. I mean, Harshad Mehta, out or in, has got nothing to do with stock prices. I mean, you can't overreact. They know that if I am in a position to buy or sell shares, I can do it being behind the bars. And if I am not, I am not able to do it outside, because I am still right now bound by so many regulations and systems and environment.
So when do you hope to get back to business? What do you see as the key shares of the future?
Frankly speaking, I am really out of touch for last 4.5 months, 5 months. So I don't want to talk anything in particular.
But without the shares that you backed, you had backed certain shares. Do you still see them as key players in the market?
I think I don't see any change in the potentials of those shares. It only depends that how things are shaping up now. And especially, I will not like to, again, I will re-emphasize that I don't want to talk on short-term. Short-term market has got into quite a lot of shocks. And let the market get absorbed, let the market get adjusted to the newer situation. But otherwise, I see the delay, whatever is taking place on the liberalization or the process, is the only delay for the stock market to move.
If you were to name the five stocks which are the stocks of the future, not the short-term future, but share investing future, what would you do? Which are the five that you would
do? Mr. Nandi, you can't get that five stocks out of me so easily. You have to pay the price for it.
What is the price?
Stock itself.
Okay. Citibank, what do you see as the future of this interface, or the future of this confrontation between you and Citibank?
I won't say I had picked up any confrontation as such. I was trying to just give out the facts. because nobody has been able to bring out except at 2-3 places some journalists have brought it out. And it becomes, again, if I am made to state the fact, I have to give the fact what all is affect in the market. And if I can help, as I have always been saying, that I am wanting to help the investigating agencies to unearth the truth, and that is going to exonerate me from the charges which has been levied. And this is one of the basic fact. So that's what I am doing it.
What was the interrogation like? What were the quizzing days like with the CBI and other investigating agencies?
Especially my experience at CBI was very tough, because in the history of CBI itself, I don't think anybody has undergone so much of so lengthy interrogations. They claim that I have a record, the number of hours, number of people.
How many?
It must have gone beyond 65 people.
65-70 people interrogating you.
65-70 people interrogating at different times with different influences, different methods, different style. Everybody has their own style, and they claim that yes, everybody is capable of bringing out the information. And they were all being like there was a competition going on there, who gets the information first. You can imagine, and I was on the other side of it.
Were they rough with you?
I won't say they're rough, rather they approach us more to build up a mental pressure. But that itself is terrible. Mental pressure, how can you stand that? So number of pages has gone beyond 500 pages interrogation. Number of hours must also be 500 to 600 hours. Number of people, 65-70 people. And number of days, I don't need to tell you.
So you've been providing employment to our investigating agencies.
No, at the end I was thinking, if there is any self-employment scheme, I can be a good interrogator myself after undergoing so much of a...
Harshad Shantilal Mehta.
Big Bull.
Man of integrity. Risk hai to isk hai.
BSC ka bachchan hai bachchan.
Is he an idiot?
I should be a hero. Dekh, main history banana chahta hoon. Aur history aise hi nahi banti.
देखो मैं सिगरेट नहीं पीता, पर जेब में लाइटर जरूर रखता हूं धमाका करने के लिए।
पर आपको पता है मेरा सबसे बड़ा क्राइम क्या है? कि मैं हर्षद मेहता हूं।
With this kind of a crowd and this kind of a heat, yes, the money was paid to the Honorable P.V. Narasimha Rao, the Prime Minister of India. People don't give human names to a scam, but if a human name is to be given to this scam, it is not a Harshad Mehta scam, it is a P.V. Narasimha Rao scam. With this kind of a crowd and this kind of a heat, yes, the money was paid to the Honorable P.V. Narasimha Rao, the Prime Minister of India. People don't give human names to a scam, but if a human name is to be given to this scam, it is not a Harshad Mehta scam, it is a P.V. Narasimha Rao scam. With this kind of a crowd and this kind of a heat, yes, the money was paid to the Honorable P.V. Narasimha Rao, the Prime Minister of India. People don't give human names to a scam, but if a human name is to be given to this scam, it is not a Harshad Mehta scam, it is a P.V. Narasimha Rao scam.
With this kind of a crowd and this kind of a heat, yes, the money was paid to the Honorable P.V. Narasimha Rao, the Prime Minister of India. People don't give human names to a scam, if a human name is to be given to this scam, it is not a Harshad Mehta scam, it is a P.V. Narasimha Rao scam.